I like this. Okay, this has got some good music. This has got a good vibe to it right off the rip. This has got a real good vibe. Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, this already goes so hard. Damn. I didn't think Fallout 3 still had it like that. Turns out it's got it like that, chat. Let's do it.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do.
I mean, this is pretty so far so good right here with the vibes.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe I don't set the world on fire.
Okay. A little eerie, a little freaky. Damn, with the Brotherhood of Steel up in the front? Okay, that's kind of fire, y'all. Uh-oh. Oh, man.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history.
Say
what? Man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes.
Damn, he says it twice? That's crazy.
In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Okay. Hey, great setup. A phenomenal setup. Music, tone, Ron Perlman, the story, the vibes. It's pretty high right now. Pretty high.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
Damn, y'all know that voice? Y'all know that voice right there, y'all?
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
That's Seamus.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're
James?
Just a... Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000.
Oh, damn. Catherine's dying.
Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
You want it. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat. This one's on the house. Fail to meet my expectations and there will be
trouble. Don't look straight into the
James
light.
James and his cheery charity.
Generations. May your future be bright. Some of this will still feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on.
These experiments
don't
are
a damn. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
congratulations,
damn, look
young
at that
man.
Beard, dude.
I don't
you're
have to tell
him,
you
Dad.
How special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities.
Oh!
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Damn, they give you a job at 10?
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Thanks, Dad.
Oh, man, you got a Pip.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we?
Nice party, butthead. Now get lost before I have to make you cry.
All right,
do you think we surprised you?
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks?
Yeah, that was sick.
And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium.
That was nasty.
Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man.
Oh,
it
let me take
really
a look at your
fun.
Wrist. You don't have a Pip-Boy, I'm do sure you, Wally? Not. So you're not even 10 years old.
Now
okay,
go
I'm going to be working the coal mines. You won't be doing shit.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
Back up, Butch. You can have it.
Right.
I don't even like
thanks,
sweet,
loser.
Sweet rolls.
Oh, and happy birthday.
What
Butch
happened
has just
to
got
Butch?
A punchable
he
face.
He looked awfully pleased with himself.
We sure can't.
Damn, they're just going to hand you a BB gun inside the vault? Door. That doesn't seem safe.
Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Okay. By the reactor? Dad, this doesn't seem safe at all. We seem to be going the opposite direction of, you know, what we should be doing for a 10-year-old's birthday. Oh, it's looking at me, Dad! Got it. Oh, yeah, let me show off
smile.
My gun, Dad. Never mind. No guns in the photo, Dad.
Different parts.
What is her problem anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter, so what? Like,
6 years later.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So,
thanks,
yes,
Dad.
You have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take.
You got a GOAT to take? What the hell's the GOAT? I like this. I like this opening so far. The vault in this is like dirty and scary and not a place that you'd want to be.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
Dad, Mr. Brock.
3 years later, so we're 19 years old now. Okay.
Selfish and insubordinate.
Just wake up.
You need
Come on,
to know
wake
those
up.
Things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on. You've got to wake up.
Oh, shit. What's going on?
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
What?
You gotta help me. My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches. No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rat roaches.
Ah, but she's a little scared.
Oh, my God. Thank you. I didn't know what to do. You are the best.
Yeah, Butch. That's what you get, Butch. That's what you get, Butch. I won't forget. I never forgot about my birthday when you stole that sweet roll from me. I don't even care about your mom. Oh, my God, your mom. Oh, they just shot Tom. Oh, my God, dude. Damn, there's the overseers. Yo, the TV show absolutely dominate. Oh, my God, the TV show's so good. Gosh darn it. Y'all need to watch that TV show. You're going to like it. I promise. I'm going to save you, Amada. I'll save you. Officer Mac, back up. Oh, we shot his head off. Oh, my God. Oh, no, it's his dad. Fuck it. I'm killing everybody. You better back up, fool.
Stop for the name of the overseer.
I'm in love with your daughter. I'm gonna spare you! Psych, I'm not sparing you! Give me your keys!
Oh God, what have you done? You killed him! Why would you kill my father?
Oh, shit, she knows. I didn't mean to. Well, I definitely meant to, because I wanted to save you. So you think she's gonna run away with me still or no? Ah! Oh, Amada! You came! Oh, I knew you loved me! I killed Butch! We'll never have to see him again. And I might have killed your father, so you don't have to see him again. Come on. Let's run away together.
Good. You're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him!
Oh, I didn't mean to! He was, like, talking to you, and I didn't want to. I'm sorry, Amada, but I had no choice.
So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No, don't listen to me. Just go. Find your father. I have to go bury mine.
I have to bury mine? Oh my gosh.
No, I can't. Not with you, not now. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
Oh, she's not running away with me. I'm leaving! I promise I'm leaving. I'm never coming back. Yeah, you guys aren't leaving the vault. You're afraid. Welcome to the wasteland of Fallout 3. There's the White House. Oh, that's so sick. Yep. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the wasteland. This is Fallout 3. And that was the Fallout 3 intro. Dang, y'all. Clap it up. Clap it up one time. Clap it up one time. It was fire. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5, too. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5. So as of right now, the ranking so far at number 1, Fallout 3. All right, so up next, we go to Fallout New Vegas. Now, Fallout New Vegas, just so you all know, released 2 years later, October 19th, 2010, coming from the dev team and the creators at Obsidian. So this is away from the Bethesda squad, but Obsidian's on the track 2 years later, October 19th. Like we brought up with all the dates, all close. Every single one except for one is in October. But November 10th is like, might as well be October. Oh, shit! We got my old save files? What? Let's see. No save found. Oh, my God. That would be crazy if it had my old save files. That was good. They got us. Don't distract me now. What you need? Oh, we're great. Yeah, yeah. Ooh! Damn, that's nasty. I forgot they had these weird, like, Roman Empire jabronis. Shit.
War. War never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn. Training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig. You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. from where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
Damn! That's kind of good. That's kind of dope. That's a fun twist. That is like a cool twist on the Fallout intro that we know.
You're awake. How about that?
Damn, do you not start in a vault? I don't remember the opening
Whoa,
of this either.
Easy there. God. Easy.
Oh, this is fun. Hercules' big cousin. Doomsday Pex, Circus Strongman, Beach Bully. Oh my gosh, Average Joe, Lightweight, Dough Baby, Doughy Baby. Oh my gosh. Eagle with Telescope, that's me. That's what they talk about me. Sniper Hawk, 100% me. Dude, I am the Sniper Hawk. Are you kidding me? Throw a baseball at me, I guarantee I catch it. Anytime you see me throw something at me, I'm gonna catch it. Are you kidding? Endurance? Unstoppable. He's bulletproof. Remember that time when Roger didn't believe that I could run a half marathon? God, it proved him so wrong. Charisma, cult leader, Casanova, movie star, diplomat. This is fun, y'all. This is sick. Intelligence, agility, just unbelievably fast. Walks on water. My luck through the roof. Yeah, get the luck up. I gotta have the luck all the way. Welcome to Fallout New Vegas. Interesting. I remember the moment that we started talking with Doc, I was like, yep, I remember this, because you're the courier. So yeah, you're not in a vault. Very interesting stuff. And you come out and that's your vault moment. Okay. Where are we ranking Fallout New Vegas? Made by Obsidian Entertainment, released October 19th, 2010. What did we think of the story, the world, the vault, the characters, the Tut, the vault opening sequence? On the opening side of things, let's start off with, they nailed the tone, like the projector vibes. Theirs were more of a desert theme, so a little bit different colorway, but they nailed the vibe of the intro, right? Then the intro video, different than Ron Perlman talking about the bombs dropping, this time talking about the tribes that had settled outside in the wasteland after the post-bomb drop and what was going on here in the southwest of the new California Republic, Caesar's army, of course, Vegas still being run by a shady entity, Mr. House. I really liked that. I liked the battle over water at the Hoover Dam and like setting up, hey, Caesar's Legion is gonna be up there on top of the hill looking down to try to take that from, I believe, what, the new California Republic? So that's kind of interesting. I like that. I love the idea of like, hey, you're a courier and you were sent on a normal job with the Mojave Express, but something bad happened and now you're waking up in Doc Mitchell's house and he's like, yo, you got shot in the head, y'all. You saw that. And now we got to pick up the pieces. No vault. The mini vault opening is definitely opening the door for the first time and being exposed. There it is. Oh, you're so right. I totally forgot about that. And that is my grave. Oh, shit. That's crazy. Wow, fucking fuck. What the fuck is that? It's a giant scorpion. He wasn't on my radar, though. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Fallout New Vegas' intro. A different vibe, a different intro, but also at the same time, you've only had Fallout 3. Yes, I know we're going to talk about Fallout 1, 2, and Tactics, whatever. But a different vibe. A different intro than what we saw in 3. No vaults. Kind of just like the chat gave it a 3 out of 5. Chat gave it a 3 out of 5. Okay. It's an okay opening. The video is good. I love the Southwest. I love the Vegas vibe of it. I love the chip. I love being a courier and being shot and like waking up out of that. I think that's fun. It just doesn't have the vault that I'm looking for, right? I want to wake up in a vault. I want to get out of the vault and have that out of vault moment. And you didn't really quite have it in that. It's more like you walk out and you're like, and I'm in Good Springs. At number one, currently Fallout 3. And then number two, Fallout New Vegas. And so we're going in to Fallout 4 up next. We're returning to Bethesda. November 10th, 2015 is when Fallout 4 released. And so we will jump in to Fallout 4. Fallout 4 released November 10th, 2015. Almost a decade ago, ladies and gentlemen. Set the tone. Set the tone. Set the tone. Get loose. Something's going on. The fuck is this?
Following total atomic annihilation, the rebuilding of this great nation of ours may fall to you. That's why we at Vault-Tec have prepared these educational materials for you to better understand the seven defining attributes that make you special.
Dang!
Got your rabbit's foot? Good. It's time we talk about luck.
The difference are they trying to win us over with a little video?
Or die in the post-nuclear world may depend on the flip of a coin.
Oh my gosh, remember?
Is a mysterious sort of curiosity. See here? A well-placed shot may not always do the trick. If Lady Luck favors you, though, you'll find those critical moments a breeze. What's this? Only scrounging up duds? Time and patience may net you a suitable collection, but with luck on your side, you're bound to find some swell keepers. No, no. Hold on to anything shiny. It may be of hidden value. Be careful not to get distracted by your newfound fortunes. Uh-oh, that wasn't the only pest. It looks like luck has helped you once again. Unfortunately, she can't save you from every situation. At least your misfortune can become someone else's fortune. Luck may be fickle, but if you can woo her to your side, the possibilities are endless. A particularly bloody mess with little chance to build a streak of destruction that cut the magic of the unexpected all. Regularly study your Vault-Tec provided materials to prepare for survival. And to answer the question, do you know what makes you special?
Okay. They try to win us over with one of those. As many of you said, hey, they have those for all of them. And yes, they did. What a fun promo they did to the lead up to this game with all of those. But, I mean, now's the intro. Now you vibe right here. Forget about that projector. Forget about the slideshow. No. This is your vibe, setting the tone of like, you're gonna probably build and you're gonna customize. And we got this sick ass power armor here and this beat. Just like Fallout 3, that's fire.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen.
Just wants to go home, y'all.
He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world of Armageddon Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war.
Dang!
And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
Damn, y'all! He hit you with the line twice! Come on,
war,
dude.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hun.
You think?
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault.
Dang!
Vault 111.
Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information, that's all.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too. Oh my God!
Ah! Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh God. Oh God. Oh God.
Sure.
Love you, babe. Take care of the baby.
Occupant vitals.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Everything's gonna be fine. Hand over the baby!
No, I got him!
Let the boy go. I'm only going to tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
Whoa! Not my wife!
Get the kid out of here. Let's go. At least we still have the backup.
Damn. That's crazy, man. They took my baby. And they killed my wife. Maybe. They kind of froze her. I don't know if she's going to die or not. Maybe we'll freeze the blood and you'll be fine. Who knows?
residents must vacate immediately.
Out of time. Exit Vault 111. Everything seems cool right now.
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on!
Another
oh,
round.
God!
My wife!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back.
Oh, are you dead, Dad, or are you
I
frozen?
I promise.
We're just gonna leave her? Close it. Let's keep her in there just in case. Maybe we can save her. I love you. I gotta go find our kid. Goddamn, this is crazy. That music is bumping right now, too. I love that, like, you come out of that, and it's like, oh, you think you're leaving? No. You still gotta take the elevator. You gotta take the elevator up. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fallout 4. Here in the wasteland of Boston, you will explore, you will settle, and you will survive.
Oh, God.
Let him know.
Dude sucks. He sucks!
The intro ends when you find Sean, Mike. That's amazing. I love that. The music is good right here, though. Not much to see. Like, I like Fallout 3 where you can really see DC and the greater area. This is like, hey, you're in a pocket. And the same goes for Fallout New Vegas, where it's like, oh, you're just in that little town. You know what I mean? I wish it was like, you know, you could see a lot more. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the opening sequence to Fallout 4. Now is your time. Share your thoughts with me. Tell me what you thought of that. See, there's a little pre-bomb drop, a little post-bomb drop, a much shorter situation than Fallout 3. The vibes are there. The music hits when it needs to hit. The pre-video story gives you war. War never changes, right? Everybody loves that. No Ron Perlman, but it still hits hard. I think it does a really good job at setting everything up and getting you excited. And then I love the pre-bomb drop. I think that's wicked dope to see in action and actually happening. I think that's really dope. I do wish, my biggest problem with this is I wish you got to embrace more vault life. But as many of you know, each vault is just a little bit different and they do things differently. So it is interesting that, like, yo, you get put into the cryo state right away, and that's what this vault was gonna do. It wasn't about living and, like, kind of having generations. It was get in there and fall asleep, and we'll wake you up when it's time, which is pretty cool when you think about it like that. But I think that's something that I love about the show. It really shows you vault life. And I think someone wrote, like, oh man, what are they gonna do with 5? Like, how do you make this fun and unique after what we've just done with 3, 4, New Vegas, and of course 76. But I think there's somewhere you could capture of, like, really living and embracing vault life. But I worry that, like, of course the game is about getting out into the wasteland and surviving and exploring. And I don't know if the vault life will be that good. But I think after you see the show, I think you're going to want more vault life. But it feels almost like, remember Assassin's Creed? It must have been Assassin's Creed 3 or whatever, when you were doing the American Revolution. And, like, all of a sudden it was like you were that one jabroni for, like, way too long. And then they were like, psych, you're not that jabroni anymore. You're finally out of the tut. And it felt way too long. I worry that, like, if we really expanded on vault life, you would be like, yo, this sucks. Just get me out. So you can't stay too long in that. But this was too short. But for the story, had a really good story, right? Like, Fallout 3, the succeeding thing was, like, you know you're leaving the vault to go find your dad. New Vegas, They just said, here's the world. Get the fuck out. We don't even want to talk to you. We don't care. At least with Fallout 4, it's like, yo, my wife was murdered. They stole my kid. Like, what am I going to do? I got to go find them. So I feel like I know what I'm doing and where I'm going. I like the intro video. I love the music. I love the pre-bomb drop. I just don't love the short experience in the vault. I love coming out of the vault and being greeted with an NPC early with Codsworth. Like, New Vegas, you're in the settlement. You get to talk right away to Sunny Smiles. Here you get Codsworth, which I like. Fallout 3, it's like, yo, you out there. Good fucking luck. And, like, that's pretty wild to me. Fallout 3 had the best vista out of the three of them so far. It was the only one where it felt like, oh, man, there's this sweeping view of DC, and you can really embrace, like, how big it is. 4 and New Vegas is like, here's a small little town. This is all you see. Hopefully you'll see more. But, like, I need that big vista. I need that sweeping vista to go, oh, man, this is crazy. This is wild, you know? Chat gave it a 5 out of 5. I'm giving it a 4 out of 5. I'm giving it a 4 out of 5. I like that it moved. I wish we spent a little more time in the vault. Maybe have something a little bit more. Have something a little bit more in there. I know it was made for cryos. But, like, I wish there was just something. Maybe a little detour. Maybe something. I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. I appreciate that the chat gave it a 5 out of 5. They liked this one. Now it's time to vote, though. Now it's time to say, is this 1, 2, or 3 on our rankings right now? Is it better than Fallout New Vegas? Yes, 100% it is. Is it better than Fallout 3? The video with Ron Perlman is iconic. It hits home. It's good. This video is right up there. I know a lot of you are going to say there's no Perlman, no way. Like I say, no Swayze, no Wayze. But like, I'm going to be real with you. The videos, they both meet. Okay, the videos, like, equal each other out. They're both good. Now, the setups for both on the stories are both very similar and both very good, right? Father runs away from the vault, causes some mayhem. He's out. Your wife gets killed inside the cryo tube, shot. They take your baby. They're out. So, like, both of them, you know what I mean? Hey, equal there. Love the stories. Love coming out of the vaults. My positive for Fallout 3 is the vault has a beautiful vista. Yeah, of course it sucks. It's a wasteland. But, like, it's got a vista. Fallout 4, no vista, but an early NPC that's fun and engaging. So, you know what? Equal there. Now, you got the pre-bomb drop. You got the post get out of the cryo tube. Here, you got a whole life sequence inside of the vault. And I got to tell you, the tunnel snakes being 16, taking the test, then being 19 and shit's hitting the fan. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm ready to give you the official kind of funny ranking on this one. At number 1, Fallout 3. Putting Fallout 4 at number 2 of our rankings for best Fallout rankings. Fallout 3 will remain at number 1. Fallout 4 goes to number 2. It is good. It is not great like the other one, and that's where it's at. It's good. It's good. It's good to great, but it's not amazing. That's it. Fallout 3, number 1. Now, you better get ready, ladies and gentlemen, because we're going to Fallout 76. Okay, it's America's Playground is the tagline on this thing. America's Playground is the tagline on this thing. Let's see if Fallout 76 can drop a bomb on all of these Fallout games. Fallout 76 released October 23rd, 2018, 3 years after Fallout 4, 10 years after Fallout 3, and now what, 6 years almost since here? This could be good. This could be a banger. I'm not sure. We'll find out together. This could be a banger. Oh, damn. They're promoting Atlantic City right off the rip. Dang. Oh! Okay, now I see you. Okay. Whoa. No way, they got the swamp thing in this video game? DC's official character, the swamp thing? That's crazy, man. Oh shit, here's the intro. Yo, they all nailed it with that one. And Fallout 76 is probably the dopest looking. It might just because of that iconic yellow.
War. War never changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage, we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76.
Hell yeah.
This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Okay. Not, I mean, not a bad video.
Vault 76. This is the Overseer. I hope you all enjoyed the party last night, even those who may have overindulged and overslept. But it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough.
Oh, shit. It's opening day.
Today is Reclamation Day.
That's so cool. That's pretty lit, though, chat. That's pretty lit. Okay, there it is. Great setup there. Reclamation Day. We're opening the vault. You've survived vault life, and now it's time to go. And, like, now you get to see, like, look at this nice vault, right? A vault that's been really lived in.
Goodbye. Aloha. Ciao.
Look at this vista. The Wayward opening soon. Food, drinks, rooms, refuge. Come on. I mean, people. So it's interesting on this one. This one feels very quick because they want you to get into the action. Had a nice video. I really liked the video. I love that we're celebrating Reclamation Day because, like, the premise of this was there was no NPCs because you were the first jabronis to ever go out into the wasteland. And I dug that. I was all about that idea back in the day. So I had no problem. Me and Kevin Asex played so much of this. We enjoyed it. But the nice quality of life additions that this team has put in with NPCs and so much more, I'm sure has gone so far. But, like, the idea of this was awesome, right? I love the idea of, like, you're the first jabronis out there. Good luck. Figure it out. And what you see inside of the vault of, like, waking up after the big party. Everyone's now gone because they've gone out into the wasteland. You're the last one to go. There is no reason to stay around and look around. It's like, hey, start moving forward, grab your supplies, head out. And then the music plus this vista of the hills, I mean, come on. It's so freaking good. And none of them have had the vista and the view of coming out of the vault like this one has. 3 had a vista, but didn't look as good as this. 7, New Vegas, and 4, not even close to this, where it looks like, oh, that's where I'm going. This is the most Skyrim Elder Scrolls opening, where it's like, oh, anything you see, you're going to. And I love that. But, it's pretty basic. It's pretty quick. It's fine, right? The chat has spoken. They're giving it a 3 out of 5 with 18 votes. 14 of you did say 2. I personally am going to fall on a 3 out of 5. That is an okay opening to a fine opening. I don't think it's bad in any way, shape, or form. I do think it is a 3 out of 5 on our kind of funny scale. Right, if we go down the list, Fallout 3, you loved Ron Perlman. Fallout 3 had a great opening cutscene that really set up the world and the bombs dropping and understanding what's going on. To then, of course, the vault life and getting out of the vault had a great story. Fallout 4, another great video setting up the world. On top of that, Fallout 4 had a good little pre-bomb drop, had a post-bomb drop, but was kind of quick. I'm not going to lie to you, kind of fast. Fallout New Vegas, great video. I loved the video of setting up the different tribes, setting up the southwest of the USA, setting up the vibe of what it is. But no vault, no grand opening, bleak vista, very rushed. Get boot it, get out, you're out of here. Where does Fallout 76 rank for you on the openings, chat? Let me see what you got. I liked this because of Reclamation Day. I liked the setup of what we were doing, what we were building, celebrating the opening of the vault. I love the vault that has been lived in, that is like really grown and matured. I love the detail, the attention to detail. I love celebrating Reclamation Day and leaving the vault. It is short. They want you to get to the action like the other games. For me, the official kind of funny ranking at the top, number 1. Fallout 3. At number 3, Fallout 76. And at number 2, Fallout 4. That is your official rankings for the Fallout opening sequences here at Kinda Funny. It goes at the tippity top, Fallout 3. It goes number 2, Fallout 4. It goes number 3, Fallout 76. And at number 4, it is Fallout New Vegas. I hope to see you in the wasteland. And everyone, have a wonderful afternoon. Goodbye, y'all. I'll see you tomorrow. For Kinda Funny Pokemon Day. Don't miss out. It's going to be a ton of fun. Bye, everybody.